Hey, I'm Coach Carl. This is a series where I go through some of the books on my bookshelf and talk about the things that I took away from them for my coaching, some of the positives, some of the negatives. And in this video, we're going to be taking a look at Daniel's Running Formula. This is the second edition. A new edition comes out every few years or so. I think they're up to number 4 right now. This is a book that isn't necessarily geared towards beginners. This is for runners who are ready to sort of take the next step in their running and are interested in getting faster. The training plans that are in here are geared towards that audience, and certainly the information presented here is geared towards a more advanced audience, a little bit more scientific backing than you see in some of the beginning running books. That said, it's very clearly written. It's very easy to read. It doesn't get lost in the weeds like a lot of the more scientific focused training books do. So this was a book that I leaned on pretty heavily when I first started at Emory. To be perfectly honest, I was probably in over my head, and this book offering concrete suggestions of how to approach training, how to structure training, was super helpful to me. I don't follow it nearly as strictly anymore, but there are a few things that have carried over through the years in my coaching that I wanna go ahead and touch on. The first is this idea that your tempo run pace should vary depending on how long your tempo run is. A lot of times people just say, oh, tempo pace, as if that's going to be the same if you're doing a 20-minute tempo or a 45-minute tempo, and it's not. And this chart right here is super helpful for adjusting your paces according to your tempo pace and how long you're going to be out there. Similarly, I really like Daniel's approach to looking at how long you have to train for the race and looking at what phase of training you should be focused on. This chart here lists out the number of weeks you have and how many of them should be spent in each phase to prepare for your race. I won't go into each phase and what it means here, you can check that out in the book if you like, but the general idea that your approach for a race if you have 6 weeks to train for it should not be the same as your approach if you have 12 weeks to train for it, I think is really important and very valid. The other section that I still find very useful is where he lays out how much you need to adjust your training for time off because of injury or illness. And I like that he breaks it down based on the number of days you had to take off and what adjustments you need to make to your training going forward to account for that. Some things that I'm not in love with in this book, FIDOT, I understand. I mean, he is obviously the one who did the studies himself. They are very scientifically sound research, I am sure. But I think for the average adult runner who picks up this book, it's a little convoluted. I think it could be a little bit more clear about what you need to be doing pace-wise based on performances without really getting as much in the weeds about VDOT. And I also think that his training plans are probably a tiny bit over-aggressive for the average adult recreational runner, and that is a point that unfortunately I'm gonna come back to a lot in this series when I talk about the different training books that are out there. Still, as I alluded to, this book provides a lot of information from the man who did most of the studies himself, and it is written in a fairly accessible way. So I think if you are someone who is looking to improve your running from the beginning level, it's tough to go wrong with Daniel's running formula. I think you just maybe want to pick and choose the information that you take from it and you apply to your own training. So that is my quick look at Daniel's running formula. If you have books that you want me to take a look at in the future, go ahead and leave them in the comment section, and don't forget to subscribe so that you can see those videos when they come out. Thanks so much for watching. I'll talk to you later.